Plane spotting at Seattle Tacoma International Airport is one of the coolest vibes out there. Today, we'll be spotting during the afternoon bank encompassing dozens of Alaska, Delta, and European widebody aircraft. So without any further delay, let's go ahead and get started, everybody. Welcome back to Seattle Tacoma International Airport. Definitely check out the first spotting video here if you missed it, along with videos on the Boeing field, Everett field, so on and so forth, as we've had so much amazing content so far through the Pacific Northwest excursion. But nevertheless, we are back here for some absolutely awesome afternoon plane spotting here at Seattle. It's going to be awesome. We are over here situated with a south flow, so there's a kind of a park area on the northwest side of the field that provides great views of these aircraft landing. So that's exactly what we have right here. So I'm super excited for this. I hope each and every one of you are as well. We're not going to waste any further time, guys, and go ahead and get started and just take a look at the leverage in the lighting already. We are already cooking. So right here, we have a Delta Airlines Airbus E220-300 landing. This lighting and view is just so awesome. So there's a little gap that they pop out at about the halfway point of the aircraft, and then we get this kind of back half angle, if you can see what I'm talking about. So that's absolutely awesome. Southwest Airlines 737 MAX 8, really cool to get another one of these here. We're going to see quite a wide variety of aircraft. There's a Atlas Air 767-300 with passenger windows. So that's really cool. And there's our first Alaska MAX 9. This one's looking really great. Hope to see MAX 8s next time I go to Seattle, which is really great to have those in the fleet now. So obviously at Seattle, much different. It's kind of that one whole airline vibe, but there's quite a bit of variety with all the Deltas, and then we're going to see quite a bit of really good international variety here in the afternoon push, so it's going to be great. Here we have the 737-900ER landing, looking quite wonderful, and here we have another E175, and we saw this one in the first video too, so glad to see it back here after its afternoon turn, so that's absolutely awesome. A little bit of haze, but that's going to get better as the sun continues to go down, which we love to see. MAX 8 landing right here. These shots are really good. I got to come back and work with some of these. I keep forgetting how powerful that T6i was. That Sigma 150-600 goes well with about any camera. Here we have another 737-900ER, and that is the same one right there, looking quite nice, just making sure, as we've seen several, so definitely don't want to miss one. And there's 305 Alpha Sierra, one of the non-wing 737-900s, so we saw 302 earlier, and now we have 305 here. I love the leverage here, and the light is getting so good already, so I mean, you can't complain with the effort right here. This is quite wonderful, to say the least. Seeing double right here, you can see the takeoffs from the spot, which is pretty cool. It is kind of far back, but obviously you can still capture. So here we have a Primera 767-300 freighter looking really nice. And I also hope to go back to Seattle and spot with the North Flow spot on the west side of the airport with Mount Rainier. That would be awesome one day. So hopefully that can happen in the future. Here we have another Delta 175. This is 301 this time. So a sister ship looking quite nice right there. So we love to see that. And an Aeromexico Boeing 737-800 looking really good. X-ray Alpha Zulu Alpha Mike looking quite wonderful right there. So of course we love to see that, looking really great. Delta Airlines Airbus E320, we also saw this one earlier, so super glad to see it again. And the angle of attack on these aircraft for their final approach can vary significantly. How about 100 years strong again? So we got a pretty good shot of it earlier, but now we definitely got the best shot of the day right there. That's absolutely awesome as the afternoon push continues for all airlines. So, man, the clarity on these shots is so good, man. The other spot was good, don't get me wrong, but we are a little bit closer on this side here, and as you can tell, it just turned out so great. Another Delta A220, this time a 100 on short final, looking really nice. These shots are so great. Delta 737-800 right here. We saw several in that first video and never going to get tired of seeing more of them as they're really concentrated up here in this area. The Alaska 175 for SkyWest, really cool to see this off that afternoon push from cities like Wichita, Omaha, so on and so forth. Our first international widebody of the day is going to be this Turkish Airlines Boeing 787-9. Super cool to see this. Of course, Turkish arriving in the afternoon hours at most airports, so that's exactly what we have with this particular example. A little earlier, the match at the bank out there in Istanbul. So really cool to see this aircraft. And a little bit of haze because this landed on the far east runway. But hey, that's completely okay as the shot still turned out well. So you can really get the leverage here and see how far out there it was. But I thought the tree shots were pretty cool here. I didn't get the best capture, but you can see what I'm going for there. So really awesome to see that, and certainly a really great capture. I've seen several of those and excited to see more of them in the near future. And here we have the Southwest 737 MAX 8 looking absolutely wonderful. And another Alaska 737 MAX 9, the sister ship to the one we flew the day before. And then we have a Horizon E175. Super excited for more videos on those in the future. And we have this Delta 175 and Alaska 737-900 I kind of missed. They also have kind of a bench area over there too, so it's not perfectly positioned to where you can capture aircraft, so you kind of have to get up and maneuver around. But again, as you can tell, the view's great, so no complaints. Delta A220-100. Looking awesome. And another 737-900ER. The various tail numbers there certainly playing their factor. And here we have an American 175 for SkyWest in from LA. So we definitely love to see that. And then we have a couple of Cirrus clouds up there. And how about this? I was testing my settings because I did not want to botch this. The Condor Airlines Airbus E330-900neo with the green stripes livery. So cool to have this. And now I have the model aircraft as well. So definitely a dynamic duo right there. This is a beautiful aircraft. This livery has definitely grown on me so much lately, and no exception to that principle here with this aircraft. Looks so awesome. I'm so glad they fly here to Seattle. So was super thrilled to get this capture. Definitely a really great one right here. As you can tell, just take a look at how stunning that is. So one to capture right here. Excuse me. This is just absolutely terrific, to say the least, and certainly a really monumental catch right there. So yeah, definitely one of the best shots I've ever got a Condor, hands down, and super glad to catch it here on this day. It looks absolutely amazing, and I'm super thrilled about it. So really great to get Condor. This is awesome, and definitely more where that came from here in the near future. That is awesome. Here's our first Velocity 737-800 in a while. Very cool to see another one at long last. And another MAX 9 there, getting several of those now. Virgin Atlantic Boeing 787-9 taxing out for departure right there. And we have a whole Alaska Horizon 175, Delta A321neo, one of the ones we saw previously, so probably did an LA or Salt Lake City flight. Another 737-900ER, and there it goes, taking off 17 left. So again, really hope to get the spot some of the aircraft that I missed last time. This was when we went to the Boeing field, when we missed that, but it was top lit again, so understandable. Here we have the 737-900ER for Alaska, and here we have this Horizon 175 in a prime air Boeing 767-300 freighter. Exceptional light right there. That is really, really awesome. So super glad to catch that right there. In a FedEx Boeing 777 freighter. Super excited to get a really good shot of these at long last. I've never really got a really good one, so that's really awesome. And was able to get a model of one recently as well. So this is just all coming together beautifully. Let's take a look at that prime one more time too, to see how beautiful that is, and then goes right into the FedEx. I believe that landed on the far runway too, so turned out really that well right there, to say the least, and was super thrilled about that. That is really awesome right there. And they had some cool flowers, so just testing settings here. And they also had these really cool butterflies as well, so I was getting some shots of those. I'm forgetting the name of them, but they're not the monarchs, obviously, the yellow ones. So cool to see those in this region. And then we have the Delta 737-800 with the scimitars. Super glad to see this one again and get some even better shots. That one right there, one of these was definitely the best one, probably that one right there. So again, super glad to get that, and we'll see some more here in a moment. So we love to see that. There goes those butterflies again, looking quite nice, making their rounds for sure. So we love to see that. Very nice, getting several angles there. And then we have an Alaska SkyWest 175, looking quite nice. And an Alaska 737-900ER, also making its rounds. FedEx taxing into the ramp right there, looking great. Another Alaska MAX 9, certainly glad to get to capture many of these, so that's awesome. And another Alaska 737-800, now Horizon 175. And a United 737-800 with the old livery landing on the far side there, so we love to see that. And then we are on to our next round of pictures. Or actually, timeout. No, we have a couple more. Sorry, I know we're towards the end, but we have a couple left. Alaska 737-800, Southwest 737-800. Certainly always a thrill to get Southwest here. And then we have the Horizon 175. Yeah, how about Spirit on their A320? This with a hybrid livery and a wardrobe malfunction, so that's really great to see. And Alaska 737-800. And we have the two cargos right there rocking and loading, so we'd love to see that. Very nice detail right there, and we're on to our next round. Alrighty, everybody, let's continue. So there's that really cool shot right there. And then how about FedEx feeder? They do have caravans in Seattle, so that's exactly what we see right here with this example. 983 is the aircraft of the day, so we love to see that. Another Delta 175, looking quite nice right there. Absolutely beautiful aircraft. And then we have Emirates taking off, as we saw in the previous video, and the Air Canada that we saw in the previous video, so that's really cool as well. Here's the Alaska 737-900ER, looking quite wonderful. And there goes Emirates. And honestly, the shots aren't too bad, so that's really cool. Delta 175 making its rounds right there. And a FedEx MD-11. That is super cool. Definitely got to do a collage with that in the 777. That is gorgeous. Love the tri-holder. So super glad to get this. And it's so cool to see them flying into Seattle. So that is a wonderful capture right there. FedEx making their rounds. Here comes their feeder caravans. There are going to be more of them, so get ready for it. I honestly completely forgot about this operation. So cool to see it. Iceland Air 767-300ER, was so thrilled to get this. I got a really good shot of one in Chicago many years ago, but it's still awesome to finally get a proper shot of an Iceland 767-300ER. Shots turned out exceptionally well considering that this was on the far runway. This one right here is phenomenal. So really cool aircraft. They're not going to be around forever. So really thrilled to get it right here. Beautiful light, great livery. Love the tail, and just that is a masterpiece. I would probably have to get a model if I can find one. So That is awesome. What a catch right there. Really, really awesome. And absolutely no denying the amazing livery that Icelandair has on the 767. That is extremely cool. So really happy about that. How could it get better than that? Now we've seen all three of the non-winglet 737-900ERs, I believe. This is 303 this time. So super glad to catch that one. That's extremely cool. Another Alaska SkyWest 175. Is United Max taking off? Here's a really cool legacy here on the E-135. This is a very cool catch right there. So cool to catch 645 pop at Mike. That is not every day you see any of those in Seattle, so that's really cool. FedEx taxiing in to join up with the 777, and there's maybe a 76 right here at the edge too. So cool to see that. Very nice. And another caravan also coming to join up with the guys. I think they do two or three rounds a day, so that's awesome. See another Delta 175. And then we have the British Airways Boeing 787-10 operating, I think, the second daily flight. So obviously we saw the 777 in the first video. Now we're seeing the 787 here later in the day. So looking really nice right there. Gorgeous looking aircraft. Love the 78X and really cool that they're flying it here on the later flight, hopefully with a full load of passengers. Ameri flight does have operations out of SeaTac. Here is the Beechcraft 1900 right here diving in after its flight from a surrounding destination. So of course we love to see that. United 737-800, really cool to see their push getting going a little bit here. I know there's Delta 757-300. They do have some of these over here. So really cool to see it here on the afternoon flight, and really makes sense for these longer flights across the United States. So that's really cool. Qatar making its rounds taking off. And another Sun Country 737-800. I think they operate to Minneapolis a handful of times a day. So that's great. Qatar making its rounds right there, as I was mentioning. And American Airlines Airbus E321 with Sharklets on short final. Another FedEx feeder caravan looking awesome. Aer Lingus A330-200 in the old livery. That's another exceptional catch right here. I keep forgetting how many afternoon flights they have. They really do go to work from 4 to 8 p.m. So really great to see this aircraft right here. As a beautiful aircraft. Haze is really starting to come down, so these shots are really starting to turn out good. So phenomenal. Love that with Irish heritage myself. That can't deny how awesome that is. So that is a gorgeous aircraft, getting some mountains back there too. Really can't complain with the effort, and these shots are just coming out so great right now. Delta A220 looking awesome right there. We absolutely love to see that. And then we are on to a Delta 737-800 because we love those. And Alaska 737-900ER. It seems like we go in banks from various aircraft to some aircraft. 7715 Echo is the aircraft I've flown in the Southwest 737-700. So certainly glad to see it here in this connotation, of course. So that's awesomeness. Looking really great. And then we continue on as the computer begins to load. Another Delta 175 in a beautiful Falcon. I think this is like a 8X, maybe, might be wrong, 9X, somewhere in there. But anyway, this is a beautiful looking aircraft, so certainly cool to catch a very unique one right here. Very different. 710 Papa Frontier finally making its rounds. This is Monty the Margray Cat, I think that's how it's said. Anyway, it's a 320 Neo. I think they just have Denver and a handful of others, so cool to see this aircraft here, but a very limited presence, but they are here, so that's great. Delta A220-300. Looking stunning right there. And a Delta 175, also in great shape. 100 years strong taking off right there. That's a very unique angle with all the FedEx planes and whatnot, so that's cool. We have this Horizon 175 in good shape right there, looking awesome. And then another Delta 737-800. They have some unique tail numbers. What did I say about One World in the previous video? We would be seeing it multiple times. Here it is again in some phenomenal light. I gotta work on these shots, man. I keep the sharpness, I keep getting a little discouraged because I have the new camera now, but I keep forgetting that these are good shots. These are not bad pictures, so definitely got to work on these. Speaking of great pictures, Delta Airlines A330-300 on the far side turning out really well considering how far out there it is. That is really great. And again, the haze has came down significantly, so in the summer you can spot that far runway pretty successfully. I mean, it's not going to be as pretty as the closer runways, but you can get it, no doubt about it. So that's awesome. Alaska 737 MAX 9, 737-900ER, Delta 175, all these are just staples here, and they're awesome. Another Delta 330 taking off. Alaska 737-800, fully loaded. You can definitely see the passenger windows there. So coming in from a Bremen destination, same song, second verse for another 739. I can't believe how many 900s they have. It just keeps slipping my mind. There's another one. But then we have the MAX 9, which they're going to keep getting more of, so stay on the lookout for those. Delta E175, nearly forgetting the aircraft type there. That's quite wonderful. Here we have the 737-900ER landing on the far runway, probably in Atlanta inbound or equivalent. And here we have this 175 too. So they have a really strong 175 presence, probably as good as Alaska's. Here we have this MAX 9 for Alaska, speaking of which, and another Delta 737-800. They do the mid-tier flights. Here we have this 175, another Horizon 175. And there's Turkish. That was an extremely quick turn, unless that was the other daily flight, which they might have too. But anyway, that seems like the same tail number. But if they got that done that quick, that's impressive. E23 November Whiskey is a Gemini Jets Delta E330-300. I did have that model. I sold it in favor of the NG, but still really cool to recognize that right here. So that's great. And I think we're on to the next round of pictures. Alrighty, everybody. So there's E23 again, looking really nice right there. So again, extremely glad to catch that. Another American E321neo, long last. Super glad to see another one of these, probably my enemy or equivalent. There goes that Turkish, again, extremely fast. SkyWest 175, looking really nice right there. And then we have the sister ship, 822, the 330 taking off right there. That's really cool. So definitely cool to see that. This time a 737-900ER for United. Really cool to get another one at long last. And then we have this Alaska 737-900ER. How many of these can we count? We'll see. Delta Airlines E220-100. There's just the right amount of 220s, to be honest. There's another 737-900 for Alaska and a MAX 9, 956 this time. So we definitely caught our good handful of those. Another SkyWest 175. And then there's another 737-900ER for Alaska. Finally, a WestJet 737-800 at long last. We got 700 earlier, so great to get this 800. I love that scimitar right there with the green, white, and navy. That is extremely cool. Good job, WestJet. That was really good effort to add that in there. There's a SkyWest 175 right there, looking really nice. And we got another Delta 737-800. These registrations, very unique. Here we have the SkyWest 175 right there, looking quite nice. Alaska really keeps their planes clean, I should mention as well. Delta 737-800 rather. Another American E321. Light is phenomenal right now, man. Loving that light. Here's a Horizon 175 that's looking really great right there. And another 737-900ER. 478 rings a bell. I don't know why, but that rings a bell for whatever reason. I'm not sure. FedEx MD-11 taking off. I'm not sure if this is, I think it's a different one, so that's really cool. Probably the aircraft we saw over on the side there moments ago. There's the United E319. Really cool to see one of these finally floating into SeaTac. And a DHL 767-300ER. That's super cool. I completely forgot we caught this. You got 767 titles there, 760 Charlie Kilo. That is extremely cool. Beautiful light, wardrobe malfunction, all the pieces you'd want. That is extremely great. So really glad to catch that right there. Completely forgot about it, but that is a exceptional catch right there, to say the least. United 737-900ER. Loving that Evo blue and this beautiful light. That is exceptionally great. Here's a MAX 9 for AK. So that's awesome, or AS rather. Here's a SkyWest America 175. Seems like the color is a little bit different there. So maybe Gemini, we can't fault them too much after what I'm kind of seeing here. Most of the aircraft are consistent, but that, these 175s certainly have been a little different. There goes Condor after a pretty efficient turnaround. We love to see that. Heading back to Frankfurt. And we have this 737-900ER for Alaska. And there's a MAX 9 now, looking quite nice. And another 737-900ER. I got down taking one to save some SD card room. And a Horizon 175. In the Icelandair 767 taking off. Another efficient turn for that aircraft too. So well done, Icelandair. That's really great. And there's a SkyWest 175, a couple clouds in the back, but they're not making a huge impact here. Aeromexico 737-800, looking quite nice right there. And Alaska SkyWest 175. JetBlue finally making it in here for the second time, it seems. A321 with the prism tail, and this is catch mint if you can. I believe that's what it says, so that's great. Really good looking aircraft right there. Love that tail. Alaska 737-700. Really glad to catch another one at long last. It's been a while, so that's great. They're pretty tough to come by, so really great to get that. Delta 737-900ER looking awesome. Spotlight for JetBlue on their A320. This might have been when the LA flights are equivalent. So really cool to see that right there. That's great. And then we have the next 737-900ER for Alaska. That's awesome. Definitely in some shade now, but there's a Delta 737-900ER before in Alaska pops out for the sun right there, so that's great. Southwest 737 MAX 8, Southwest making their rounds. They have a good presence. Delta A321neo, loving that light right there. That is gorgeous, so of course we love to see that. There's Southwest 737-800, and there it is. We've been waiting for this aircraft the whole day, the EVA Air Boeing 787-10. Really glad to get EVA Air. I've not really caught much EVA Air in my time, so that's really cool. Bravo 17805. Beautiful light, beautiful all of it. This is really great. Was so glad to be able to wait for this aircraft to arrive. Look at that light. Look at those engines. That is absolutely amazing right there. Really great looking aircraft. Love the tail, and ultimately some really great variety for my aviation photography there. So that is a gorgeous aircraft. Love that. Got the mountains in the background too. too, and I think I edited one of these shots probably around here. Really great clarity, and it just turned out so well. So super thrilled to catch EVA Air, and that's just absolutely awesome right there. And kind of like that shot there, it really encapsulates Seattle really well with some cargo and the Alaska there along with some mountains and the trees. That's awesome, and certainly super glad to see that right there. That is quite terrific, to say the least. Another Alaska 737-900ER, and that is the last aircraft of today's amazing spotting session. So I really hope each and every one of you enjoyed this. Seattle spotting was so much fun, and we're going to get to do more of it coming up, so stay on the lookout for that. Love Seattle. It's a great place. A little bit more expensive for me to get to particularly, but definitely we'll be coming back in the future to do even more, and we have some really exciting videos still to come, so I really hope all of you are excited on it for Seattle, and then we take it up to a nearby city for our first time in Canada. So I really hope all of you are excited for it. But nevertheless, that'll do it for today's video, everybody. Thank you all so much for watching. I want to thank each and one of you for watching. My name is Redriveraviation. Take it easy, everybody. Stay safe. Test process. Do you love and love you do? My name is Redriveraviation. I want to thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all soon as Redriveraviation is signing off.